Hi Gemini, this is your June 14th through June 20th weekly tarot reading. Happy birthday if you're celebrating this week. I do 5 separate spreads in my weekly readings. We'll have a spread on new love, a separate spread on love in an existing relationship. I'll do an X spread. We'll talk about your work, your business, and your finances, and we'll see what you're not expecting to happen this week. Please like, subscribe, and donate to support this channel. This first spread is on new love. This week, we have the Sun, we have the Ten of Cups, we have the King of Swords in the potential outcome, we have the Ace of Cups with the Fool and the Ten of Pentacles, and we also have the Page of Cups on the bottom of the deck, and I just couldn't resist it. I looked underneath the Page of Cups, and we've got the Ace of Wands. You could be dealing with an air sign, another Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius. A very interesting spread, and straight to the point, to be honest with you. I didn't even have to clarify anything on the left. This King of Swords right there in the middle, it could be your energy, Gemini, because you are an air sign, male or female, absolutely doesn't matter. But for most of you, it's going to be a new person, this new love person, new love interest coming into your life. This person could be another Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius. And it kind of looks like it could be another Gemini, to be honest with you, because we've got every single element on the table. We've got Cups, Wands, Pentacles, Swords, right? And we also have a couple of Major Arcana cards along with those cards. But it could be any air sign. So what I'm feeling is this person is like your mirror reflection. This person is definitely going to be someone on the same page with you. You will have very similar ideas, very similar goals, and the two of you will have immediate chemistry. The two of you will click from the get-go, because the first two cards that came out are the Sun and the Ten of Cups. Right from the get-go, there is a commitment, and there is the happiest card in the deck, right? Very symbolic. The Sun, like I just said, is the happiest card in the deck, and the Ten of Cups right next to it. One of the names for the Ten of Cups is the Happily Ever After. So you see what I mean? The happiest card in the deck with the Happily Ever After. There you go. The Ten of Cups is actually one of the commitment or marriage cards. If having children is still an option for you, the two of you could definitely have children together, because in the Ten of Cups there's two adults and also a couple of kids jumping around. So like I said, the two of you are like a perfect match. Right, this person is definitely on the same page with you. We have the Page of Cups with the Ace of Wands on the bottom of the deck. So the Page of Cups is what happens in the beginning of pretty much any relationship. This is them buying you a drink, or this is them asking you out, just being super nice to you, giving you compliments, giving you flowers, sending you text messages, or sending you pigeons with paper messages. Whatever they're or you're into. And the Ace of Wands right underneath the Page of Cups, it's going to get really hot, right? So the two of you will sort of recognize each other. The two of you will see right away that you are pretty much of the same kind, right? In the potential outcome, we have the Ace of Cups with the Fool and the Ten of Pentacles. The Ace of Cups is a second ace. The Ace of Cups is one of the best cards when it comes to love offers. It's always about a genuine, authentic love offer. The next card that came out is the Fool. The Fool is all about taking a leap of faith. So very like you, Gemini. I'm not judging you. I'm a Gemini myself. Wink, wink. Some of you already know that. But the Fool is all about, yeah, let's just see what happens. Let's play by the ear. It seems like the two of us click. We have instant chemistry. And let's just see what happens, right? And what happens is amazing. Because like I said, the first two cards that came out are all about pure joy and happiness and a family. But the last card that came out in the potential outcome is the Ten of Pentacles. The Ten of Pentacles is kind of similar to the Ten of Cups. It's also a family or a commitment card, but the Ten of Pentacles is more on the practical side, right? So this is a card of when people buy real estate together. This is a very serious, very grounded type of a connection and very long-term type of a connection, right? This is when people grow old together, have children together, if that is still an option for you, then grandchildren come along. So you've got the best of both worlds. You've got the Ten of Cups and the Ten of Pentacles. So an emotional fulfillment and also practicality and also financial security with the Ten of Pentacles, right? So yeah, this person is right down your alley, your mirror reflection, your perfect match. And there's two commitment cards on the table, two aces, and the happiest card in the deck, the Sun card, and it came out first. So, Gemini, happy birthday if you're celebrating this week. I'm really happy for you. Congratulations. Gemini, if you are already married or if you are in a relationship, this spread is for you. We have the Nine of Swords, we have the Six of Swords, we have the Hierophant, and we also have the Ace of Swords on the bottom of the deck. You could be dealing with a Taurus. I can interpret this spread a couple of different ways. Scenario number one is perhaps you were thinking that this person whom you're with will never propose. You didn't know where this situation or this connection is going, and therefore you were really stressed out, you were even kind of depressed, you were having anxieties, right? So this week, you will know where the two of you are heading, and you're heading towards a commitment. So they will do something with that Ace of Swords on the bottom of the deck that will finally bring in clarity, that will finally set the record straight, that will finally tell you that there's definitely a commitment here. Because the Hierophant right next to the deck, if it's not a Taurus you're dealing with, then the Hierophant is about something traditional, like a committed relationship or marriage. And the Six of Swords right next to it, to the left, this is a card of movement. So you're moving out of that Nine of Swords energy where you're stressed out and depressed, and you're moving towards a commitment. All of that because of that Ace of Swords on the bottom of the deck, which is a very straightforward and direct communication. I don't know if you're going to be the one initiating this conversation, but somebody will, for sure. And if that is something that's heavily on your mind, and I believe it is, you can start this conversation. Just don't, you know, stop suffering. Especially if you've been together for a while. Just don't give them an ultimatum. Do not do that. But you know, tell them straight up, you know what, we've been together for such and such a long time, we're in love with each other, what's next? And I think they will tell you what's next, and what's next is a commitment. For others of you who are already in a committed relationship, the two of you, perhaps you think that your relationship or your marriage is on its last leg, or it became stale, it became boring, and you've been thinking that this relationship or this marriage is coming to an end. And I'm going to give you the same advice as I just gave to the first group of Geminis, right? Speak up. That's all. Voice out your opinion. Just say what's on your mind. And I think this person will have that conversation with you, and I do see a restoration of your connection to its former glory, because the Six of Swords with the Hierophant right there, this is still an improvement. This is a rough patch being over, and your relationship is sort of moving back to its, or being restored to its former glory with that Hierophant card. But somebody's got to talk with that Ace of Swords. All right, cool. Let's see if anybody comes back from the past for you, Gemini, this week. Keep in mind, it could be somebody from a couple of months ago, a year ago, or a couple of years ago, so it doesn't have to be the most recent ex. Also, keep in mind, we are still in Mercury retrograde. Yes, we still are. And this is when more exes than usual show up. Right, so we have the Three of Swords, we have the Knight of Pentacles, we have the Wheel of Fortune. In the outcome, we have Temperance with the Empress and the Lovers, and we also have the Eight of Cups on the bottom of the deck. You could be dealing with an Earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. You could be dealing with a Sagittarius or another Gemini. So somebody here will make a really, really, I want to say, impressive attempt to reconcile with you. The problem here is that this person broke your heart, because the first card, the very first card that came out is the Three of Swords, and the Three of Swords is like a very clear indication that this person put you through something major. The Three of Swords is a card of a broken heart, this is a card of a betrayal, this is a card of a breakup, it's also a card of a being stabbed in the back. So whatever this person did to you, you know, it took a toll on you, for sure. We have the Eight of Cups on the bottom of the deck, all the way to your right. This is somebody coming back from the past, right? The Knight of Pentacles right next to the Three of Swords. It could be an Earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn coming back. Or the Knight of Pentacles represents a very serious offer coming from this person. And the Knight of Pentacles is the slowest knight out of all four knights. So this person thought this offer through, probably because they realized how screwed up you felt, screwed over, after what they did to you. So the only way for them to get back into your good graces is to present you with this very, very serious offer with the Knight of Pentacles, right? We also have the Wheel of Fortune. The Wheel of Fortune is a restart of a new cycle. This is what this person wants. In the outcome, we have Temperance with the Empress and the Lovers. Temperance is either a Sagittarius you're dealing with, or Temperance is all about healing, burying the hatchet, reconciling, getting back together. Here's where it gets very interesting, Gemini, because the next two cards that came out, I believe those two cards symbolize you, both of them do. Because the Lovers, that is your personal card, Gemini, unless you're dealing with another Gemini. And I think in this spread, the Empress is also you, right? So you have completely healed from what this person did to you, and you're very relaxed right now. You've learned your lesson, and you definitely know your worth right now. The Empress is somebody who does not require an introduction, because everybody knows who the Empress is. The Empress is very relaxed, sitting back on her throne, and she knows, or he knows, that she'll be fine, you know? She'll be fine either way. So I think it's going to be 100% up to you, Gemini, what you want to do here, and it's always a good sign to have your own card in your own reading. And the Lovers, like I said, that is your card. That means you're definitely the one in charge, and you're definitely the one calling the shots here, right? So it all depends on what this person actually did to you in the past. And as I always say, if somebody really, really screwed you over in the past, then it appears to be the case here. Chances are they will do it again. But if this Three of Swords is just, you know, You felt brokenhearted, but it wasn't really anything messed up, then perhaps you can find some space in your heart to give him a second chance. So 100% up to you, Gemini. Let's talk about your work, your business, and your finances, Gemini, this week. But I gotta warn you, it's not a positive message. Perhaps some of you still need to hear it. We have the Five of Wands, we have the Five of Swords, we have the Five of Cups, and we also have Death on the bottom of the deck. You could be dealing with a Scorpio. Something is coming to an end, and it's not going to be pretty. All right, so we got three fives on the table, and you can look up what that actually means. And I'll just tell you that the Death card on the bottom of the deck falls sort of nicely in line with the three fives. Something is definitely coming to an end, and it's going to be, you will have a few words to say on the way out. We've got two fives. Both of them are cards of a fight or a card of a conflict, right? So if you don't want to quit your job this week, then just be careful what you say, to be honest with you, because then you may regret it. The last card that came out is the Five of Cups. This is a card of a regret. So you may regret it later. If you think that something has reached the boiling point, just take some time off. Take some time off. I think you can still avoid this if you don't really want it. Because if you say something, it will definitely escalate. Got two fives here, two fight cards, two conflict cards, two breakup cards, and the Five of Swords in the middle. This is when somebody says, you know what, screw it, I'm out of here. So I'm not judging you, I'm just warning you. If you want to keep your job, just be careful what you say this particular week. You can still avoid it. If somebody insulted you, then take it to HR. You know, don't take matters into your own hands. So be careful. Let's see what you're not expecting to happen, Gemini, this week. We have the Hierophant, clarified by the Four of Cups. We have the Nine of Wands. We have the Six of Swords. And we also have the Two of Swords on the bottom of the deck. You could be dealing with a Taurus. Somebody is going to make you an offer, but your answer is going to be no. This spread could be about love, but it could also be about work, business, and finances, right? So the first card that came out is the Hierophant. The Hierophant is the personal Taurus card. You could be dealing with a Taurus. But if we want to stay general, then the Hierophant is about something traditional or official. If this is a work or a business offer, then this offer is serious. This offer is legit. If this is a love offer, then this person is offering you a committed relationship or marriage. But your answer is still going to be no, because the Four of Cups clarifying the Hierophant, this is a card of a rejection. And we also have the Two of Swords on the bottom of the deck. And in this particular spread, I believe the Two of Swords, this is you saying no. This is you remaining closed off to this offer. All of that is because of the Nine of Wands right there in the middle. The Nine of Wands is a card of a wounded warrior. So perhaps you already know this person, or you already know, you already dealt with this company. If this is a work or a business adventure offer. So something is off about this person or this offer, and therefore you are saying no because of your past experience with this particular person or this particular company. And there you are with the Six of Swords. Moving on, the Six of Swords is actually a card of an improvement, right? So things are about to get better either way for you, but you're definitely saying no to this offer. All right, Gemini, so that's what I got for you for this week. If this video resonates with you, please like it. Happy birthday one more time if you're celebrating this week. And other than that, Gemini, have an amazing week. And there you have it. This was your tarot reading for this time period. I hope it resonated with you and helps you live a better life one way or the other. Thank you for watching, sharing, and subscribing.